and welcome to my channel. It's Bev with Native Touch Natural. Okay, so I want to just drop in and say I am done with the Doug's Amazing Detox. I finished the 10 days, but I'm just going to keep it totally real. I can't be nobody but real, right? All right, so keeping it real, I want to tell you that if you've watched my other videos from, you know, the first day up through day 6, you know, you'll see what I had going through in those days. But my day 7, 8, 9, 10 became so challenging. It was so challenging for me to, you know, do the detox for a number of reasons. I did it, I completed it, but it took me longer than the 10 days that it was supposed to take. And a couple of days was strictly because I wasn't at home to do it. And like I said, because in one of the other days, I noticed that because of how potent Doug's Amazing Detox is, it really works on your system. And I go to the bathroom a lot, you know, and then with drinking all the water you're supposed to drink and so on and so forth, it had me going more. And so I was kind of just wanting to kind of stay close to the home, if you know what I mean, because things were coming up and out every single day I drank the detox. But then on the day 7 through 10, I also noticed that because my stomach had shrank, it was harder for me to drink it. So imagine like this. This was the mason jar. This was my mason jar that I used every day of the detox. And then some of the days, this is a 24-ounce jar, and it was full. And then some of the days, depending on what I mixed together as far as my fruit, it would yield almost like 32 ounces, about 30 ounces. And so I had to pour some in a different jar, you know, the excess, but I would still get it down. I would still drink it. So yes, imagine this every day. This is a 24-ounce jar that I used for mixing my detox in every day of the detox. And it just became so hard to get it all down. On like day 7 and 8, I struggled immensely because I would get full. I would be drinking it. I would be drinking it down. And then I would just get so full, I couldn't finish no matter what I did. I just could not get it down. I would feel stuffed because eating the way we've been eating on the detox, my stomach shrank. And I just could not force anything else in no matter what I tried and psyched myself up saying, I gotta get it down. And I just couldn't. So for 2 days straight, I struggled with, because it was more than 2 days straight. Because on one of the days, it actually took me 3 days to get down this one jar. And I wasn't eating and drinking a lot of other stuff, making it difficult. You know, I was eating my salad every day as, you know, I was just following the recipe, even on Christmas Day, because I was still on a detox on Christmas Day. Even on Christmas Day, I stuck to it. I ate exactly the way I was supposed to eat on Christmas Day. All I ate was my oatmeal in the morning, and I ate my lean meat and vegetable for dinner while everybody else was eating mac and cheese and all that. I stuck to it because I was determined I was gonna get it down and get it down right. I was determined, even though it was taking me longer than the 10 days. So that was my experience. So let me just recap. On day 2 is when I noticed a lot of mucus was breaking up in my body, and I did develop a headache, which was, you know, normal. I did develop a headache, but you know, I needed to really pump in more water to help with the dehydration and then the effect of the detox. You got to get that minimum 64 ounces of water in. That is key. But every time I detox, I end up with a headache, you know, on the front end of the detox. I always do. So that was normal for me. And I noticed that I had a sheet because I was actually remembering what happened each day. And so I did feel a little achy on day 2. I got lethargic, completely lethargic at the end of the day, and I just didn't want to do much but to lie down. And then the parasites were coming out Oh my God, they were coming up and coming out. Okay. Yeah, lots. There were lots. And on day three, I still had like a mild headache. That's when I also noticed that my tongue was feeling milky. So mucus was coming up and it was coating my tongue. And so I scraped that off. And that was a sight. It won't get graphic on you on that. And my taste buds had become so heightened to where the flavors of everything I ate was just more robust and I could just taste it more, especially pepper. Pepper does something to me this way, you know, I noticed really the pepper. And then days 4 through 6 was more mucus, and I had lost a total of 8 pounds by day 6. But I am so happy to say that upon completion of the detox, I was down a total of 10 pounds, and that was with me sticking to it, even though I wasn't able to get it all down, you know, each day, get the whole 24 ounces down as instructed. But still, nonetheless, I got it down. You know, I would not let it go to waste. I said, I'm going to do this hook or crook. And so I am very pleased. I highly recommend that if you're looking for an absolute and potent detox experience, that you would give Doug's Amazing Detox a try. And so that was my, you know, wrapping it up, you know, my experience with doing Doug's Amazing Detox for the very first time. And I will be doing it again because it is the truth. It has worked better than any detox I have done in the past. And I've done it plenty. Okay. And so this one has been the most potent. So thank you for watching. And, you know, if you want to catch up, just, you know, go through all the videos from day one up to now to see, you know, what it was done. And then you also notice, because I noticed just looking back at my own videos, my face is smaller. So, you know, that's a clue. It was working. My shoulders are not so broad. So, yes, it has definitely done wonders for me. I love the experience. Would most definitely do it again. And I highly recommend it. So, thank you for watching. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button.